Hi, I'm Dr. McCleary from Orlando Orthopaedic Center, one of the sports medicine physicians. We're going to talk a little bit about diagnosis of concussions. Diagnosis is actually a very difficult part when it comes to concussion. Unfortunately, there are not a lot of very good reliable tests that can conclusively diagnose a concussion. Most of what it comes down to is the history of the event of what happened, which can come from the athlete themselves. A lot of times it can be coming from a coach or an athletic trainer or a parent that witnessed the injury, and certainly the aftermath of the injury to see how the athlete reacted and was acting after the injury. That is actually ends up being the most critical feature of how we diagnose concussions. Now, there are some physical exam findings that we oftentimes will look for, especially immediately after the injury, such as things with checking your balance, checking your testing short-term memory and other types of memory recall from earlier in the day and those types of things. And those things are both best done immediately after the injury. Now, when we're seeing them in the office after having had a suspected concussion, it gets more difficult. Most of the time, the physical exam findings are going to be normal. One of the things we're actually looking for on physical exam is to see if there's anything that could mimic a concussion but could be a more serious problem, such as a bleed in the brain or a more severe head trauma. So that's actually one of the main things we're looking for on the regular physical exam. Other diagnostic tests such as MRIs and CT scans by definition are going to be normal for concussions. So those are going to be, if they were done, are going to be normal. Now there are computerized testing that we do. Now that's actually intended to be used for follow-up of the concussion to monitor the progress to see how well they're responding. It's typically not used as a true diagnostic tool. Now there are lots of other things out there that people are studying. They're studying different types of specialized MRIs. They're studying different types of blood tests and things like that. So then the horizon, there may be some testing that can be done in the future to more conclusively diagnose concussion. But as it stands right now, we're relying mostly on the history, a little bit of physical exam, and more importantly, ruling out the other bad things that can look like a concussion initially.